You obviously knew that Jimin is gonna win at the end, and that's how the ending is what makes this episode better than Bad Luck's Back. Because the ending knows how to end an episode right. Jimmy managed to save everyone from Eddie's evil plan by having the Delta Waves completely destroying everyone, and he completely destroys it. And then out in front of the parents, he completely fights the baby. Yes, I'm really not making this up. They actually did that. Just wait, when they're at the end. Everyone is really furious at Jimmy until that there's actually Delta Waves inside of Eddie's rattle. And then he throws it and explodes, and he completely talks out in the open. Which means that Jimmy wins at the end. And not only that, it ends right there. The parents completely take away Eddie and put him on a baby leash, and Jimmy wins at the end with no stupid joke. That's how an ending of a serious episode should be, even for an 11-minute episode. That's why this episode is better than Bad Luck's Back. Anyway, since I talked about those two episode stories, let's talk about the characters. Now, for some reason, they gave Tak two personality traits, being a wild idiot and sometimes a serious character. However, when they make him a serious character, it just doesn't work for me. You wanna know why? Because it just feels so rushed just for this episode. Why would they make him a smart character in situations like this? And not only that, the problem with two character traits is that I can't relate to this character no matter what. I just can't. I mean, I get that they're trying to make him like in the video games, but it just doesn't work when you make him a complete idiot. And that's not even the major problem with this episode. People say that this show is kind of like the SpongeBob formula in the post-movie era. And they're kind of right. But when it comes to serious episodes like this one, I still think that this is kind of similar to the Jimmy Neutron episode. For several reasons. The mild characters are just like the characters in Jimmy Neutron, but the humor is just weak and not even trying. Now, I know I'm missing the point that this is kind of like the SpongeBob formula, and I do understand where the fans of Nick are coming from, but the major problem with that is that I'm speechless. I mean, I don't understand why the people who made this show just makes this kind of like SpongeBob. I just don't. That's why I'm speechless. I mean, I know people see this show a little more than me, but from my point of view, I've seen this similar to the Jimmy Neutron cartoon. That's all I can think of this being similar to the SpongeBob formula. Now, the mild characters are very hilarious. Sure, in season 3, they might get annoying, especially for Sheen, but for what it is, it's pretty hilarious. Especially that Sheen just completely overreacts, that he's just trying to do the dirty stuff, and then at the end, he just says, "I did all that for nothing." That is pretty hilarious. As for Carl, he's just doing his charm as usual, but Cousin Annabelle is just basically out of control. He just has a lot of issues and has some psychotic attacks if something happens, which is really hilarious. And the reason why these characters are way better than the ones in Tag is because they're actually funny for the most part. I mean, they did blob everything during the past of Jimmy Neutron. And when they tried to get along, they can't because they lost the respect from everyone because of Jimmy Neutron. Reasons why this episode is a great episode. I'm not getting to the main villain just yet, but I'm getting to it closely. Anyway, let's talk about the beginning of the episode. It had a great setup for this episode. Have the Neutron family not getting along because of Jimmy Neutron, and Jimmy Neutron trying to win Animator over, and then his invention completely exploded, and everyone blames Jimmy. It makes sense. So Jimmy Neutron has to stay in the house before Animator wise Hugh and Judy Neutron out of the will. Which is a very good setup to this episode, and what's gonna happen later in the episode. And the real villain who is behind all this is Eddie, Before any of you ask, I really don't think that this is the best villain from the show, obviously. But here's the reason why this villain is better than the other two characters from the TAC cartoon. He's just basically the Stewie Griffin from Family Guy but toned down for kids. And the reason why I'm not giving this character any hate is because he's a baby. And to be quite honest, when you're a baby, I just got nothing else to say about him. I just don't. I really got nothing else to say because he's a baby who doesn't have any development when you're born. But the main reason why he wants to get rid of Jimmy Neutron is because he wants Animander's fortune. That's basically his goal. And you know what? Babies always get the fortune for parents, which is why he has this goal to get rid of Jimmy Neutron. Which is why I can understand that. Now, his jokes and dialogue, kind of like Stewie from Family Guy, and it's kind of hilarious at the same time, but I still think that Stewie is better than him, but that's not the point. He's really not a terrible character when you get to know him a little more, but he's really not a good villain. If there's anything that this episode takes it away from being a very great episode, it will probably be his dialogue and stuff, since all he ever says is baby stuff and diaper stuff. And not only that, he only appears in two episodes. This one and the finale from the show, which is The League of Villains. I really can't blame the show for that because the company who was behind the show got defuncted because of the poorly box office from Aunt Bully. So, I really can't blame the show for that. I can just kind of respect the fact that this show wasn't continued for the fourth season because of the stuff that happened during 2006. So, that's why the show didn't continue in 2007. I mean, I wish it continued and pretty much fixed everything, but I really can't blame the show on that. It's really sad that after 10 years, the show never continued. And I've heard that they might reboot this show. Now, what is my opinions on this episode? It's not one of my favorite Jimmy Neutron episodes, and I can understand that Jimmy Neutron has its duds, but it's still a very enjoyable and good episode, and it's better than Bad Luck's Back. Sure, you may not see it closely, but in my point of view, they're kind of similar in some episodes. I'm not saying that both of these shows are similar, just when the characters are involved, the kind of. I just always think of TAC kind of being similar to Jimmy Neutron, except that he does magic instead of machines and stuff. But I just got nothing else to say about the show, other than that it's just similar to Jimmy Neutron, and I need to find an episode that is similar between this episode and a Jimmy Neutron episode. Anyway, I'm Lonely Fanboy Filet here, and please, just ignore the cartoon and just play the video games, if you're a gamer, that is.